Hey guys, in this video I'd like to discuss about AC inhibitors. So before starting off with AC inhibitors, let's try to understand how renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system works in our body. So to understand that, let's see where renin is produced from. So renin is produced from the kidneys. So whatever renin which is produced, what it will do? It will convert an enzyme angiotensinogen. What is it? Angiotensinogen. So the word itself is saying tensinogen. It is a inactive form, angiotensinogen to angiotensin 1. That is AT1. Okay. Who is doing that function for us? That is done by our renin. So renin converting angiotensin. Angiotensinogen to angiotensin 1. So the converted angiotensin 1 will get converted into something called angiotensin 2. So this function of converting angiotensin 1 to 2 is done by an enzyme called angiotensin converting enzyme, that is ACE, angiotensin converting enzyme. It converted angiotensin 1 to the angiotensin 2. So this angiotensin 2, whatever formed, it will have an effect of vasoconstriction. By acting on the angiotensin receptors. So this angiotensin 2, which causes vasoconstriction, will elevate the blood pressure. Now let's see, angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitor. Means what they are doing? Angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors are the drugs which inhibit the angiotensin converting enzyme and prevent it forming angiotensin 1 to angiotensin 2. So this is the very simple mechanism of the angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors. See, when I am talking about vasoconstriction, that will elevate the blood pressure. If I block this enzyme, if I don't have this enzyme, there is no angiotensin 1 to angiotensin 2. There is nobody to cause vasoconstriction. Now let's see what else angiotensin will do. Angiotensin 2, whatever is formed, it will stimulate aldosterone also. What aldosterone will do? It will increase the sodium and water reabsorption in the kidney and cause the elevation of the blood pressure. Now let's see, if I don't have this angiotensin converting enzyme, no angiotensin 2 and there is no aldosterone. So these are the two ways it can decrease the blood pressure. Now, so what is the use of the angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors? Of course, it's very simple. They are used for treating the hypertension, right? So let's see the names of the angiotensin converting enzyme. So angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitor, everything ends with enalpril. Everything ends with a pril, that is enalpril, captopril. So we have something like lisinopril, right? So these are the drugs which work as a ACE inhibitor. Means everything is ending with a pril. Among all the prils which are AC inhibitors, enalpril is a prodrug. So prodrug means which is inactive, it goes into the body, it undergoes metabolism and gives some active metabolite which work as a ACE inhibitor. Now let's see one important thing about ACE itself. So ACE, what is the function of ACE? The word is clearly saying that converting of angiotensin 1 to angiotensin 2, but ACE is required also for breaking bradykinin. What is it? Breaking bradykinin. Bradykinin is a inflammatory mediator. It is also broken down by ACE. Now let's see, when I am using ACE inhibitor, what will happen? I don't have this ACE, so there is no breaking down of bradykinin. What bradykinin will do? It is an inflammatory mediator, so it will trigger the dry cough. So one of the side effects caused by ACE inhibitor is dry cough. So dry cough is one of the side effects caused by AC inhibitors. What else it can also called? It is an inflammatory mediator and it also have a effect on the blood vessels, so it can cause angioedema. What is it? Angioedema. So these are the side effects caused by AC inhibitors. So we didn't discuss important thing. Where do we use these drugs? Where do we use these AC inhibitors? So AC inhibitors, of course we know one important use, that is antihypertensives. So these comes, AC inhibitors comes under first line antihypertensive drugs. Now let's see the uses. So one use, that is hypertension. Apart from that, we can also use it in the diabetic nephropathy. Diabetic nephropathy. Why? Because these are the nephroprotecting drugs. These are also used during the congestive heart failure. So these are the drug, these are the uses for the ACE inhibitor. Now let's see important contraindication. One of the important contraindication for ACE inhibitors is bilateral renal stenosis. Bilateral renal artery stenosis. It is one of the important contraindication for the ACE inhibitor. Apart from that, it is also not used in pregnant women. So these are the contraindications for ACE inhibitor. So before finishing the video, I'd like to give a brief list of the drug, list of the groups which are used in hypertension. So we have some group of drugs which are always the first line for the treating the patient who is having hypertension. So let's see which are the groups we use in that condition. So one we know already, ACE inhibitors. Okay, the second one is angiotensin receptor blockers. So they are called as ARBs. They are also called as ARBs. We can also use beta blockers. The next group of drugs which we use is, that is diuretics. So these are the some important group of antihypertensive drugs which can be used as a first line antihypertensive drugs. Anyways, I will make further videos about drugs. I will also make drugs with angiotensin receptor blockers. There is video already about beta blockers. There is video about diuretics. And I have already uploaded a video about calcium channel blockers, which are also used as a first line treatment for treating the hypertension. So this is a story of our ACE inhibitors. Thank you guys. Keep watching.